Washington County Sheriff's Department was notified about 7 this morning of a body near the Greenville waterfront. The name of the person is being withheld pending further investigation. Authorities tell us the deceased is a male between the ages of 55 and 60. The body has been sent to the state crime lab for an autopsy. Well, police continue an investigation after 3 people are injured in weekend shootings. The Greenville Police Department reports the first shooting happened about 12:30 Sunday night in the 900 block of Highway 82. When officers arrived, they were met by a large crowd. During that time, several gunshots were fired. One victim was shot in the leg. Police later discovered a second person had also been shot in the leg. Only a couple of hours later, around 2:30 that morning, police were called to yet another shooting, this time in the 400 block of Maple Street, where a 19-year-old was shot in the chest and arm. Victims could not identify a suspect. Anyone with info is urged to call Greenville Police or Crime Stoppers. Well, in other news, while school is out for students, an area principal is getting back together a little early, and a Delta author had some tips he wanted to share. WXBT's Casey Freeman has the story.
Delta native and author Clifton Talbert returned home to talk to local principals.
When a principal sees himself or herself as the North Star, that places them in a position not only of being light, but being able to provide the information that is needed to accomplish the goals that have been set forth. And as we well know, that in our country, education has always been important,
in the education
but because of advances in technology, it is more important than it has ever been before.
Talbert also plans on teaching about why it's important for educators to stand together.
That community of people doing like things, that's always important. To know that your problems are not just yours, but also to know that the things that have gone well, things that I find to be very important, is to intentionally have conversations about what we are doing in order to accomplish the good that we know need to be accomplished.
He goes on to explain why coming back to the Delta is so rewarding.
I tell the stories of the Mississippi Delta, and these are the books that I write. This is where my first grade teacher lived. This was her home. This is where she died. And that's foundational to everything that I am today. And as I would tell the principals, that even though they're in July of 2016, but 50 years from now, there will be a student somewhere on this planet that will remember their touch and what they've done in their lives.
At Delta State University, Casey Freeman, WXBT, your Delta News.
And Talbert is originally from Glen Allen.